A very good morning to you all across Australia. It is nice to see you all on this Monday morning, bright and early and bushy-tailed.
That's right. It's a good start to a Monday when you get your favourite song
exactly.
playing as well.
I love this song. I love this song. Good morning to you, Alicia.
Good morning,
nice
Carl.
To see you.
Good morning, Lisa.
Good morning, all. How are our weekends collectively?
Good.
Collectively excellent.
A collective
you
good.
Concur?
Pretty good, yep.
She worked.
Pretty
worked.
Good.
Yeah. I worked. It was great.
That's a good
answer,
weekend.
Dory. Good answer. Oh, Loxley, sorry. Get your maiden name.
Should have hyphenated. Take it home, Carl.
Just quietly, how good a term is maiden name?
Yes.
Does that fire you up?
You boys don't have that, do you?
Maiden name. It suddenly just occurred to me.
Your maiden name is Stefanovic.
Yeah, it doesn't change.
Yeah.
You could change it.
What about you, maiden?
Times are a changing.
Yes. You damsel in distress, you.
You filly.
Why don't you go and milk some cows? Sorry. Sorry.
In fact, should you even be out of the kitchen?
I know.
I think so, exactly.
I've been allowed out.
Shouldn't have said it.
Yeah.
It's not bad, is it? 86 years of age and still coming up with new thoughts on the whole process.
We should have had a disclaimer before that hedgehog stuff. That was too full on for morning television.
You're a bit of a fan of hedgehogs. Would that be your favourite animal?
Yeah, I
can see why you like hedgehogs.
They are good.
I love a meerkat.
He's a very famous actor with the nickname Hedgehog that Carl's thinking about right now.
Yeah. Let's keep moving.
We didn't take it there. You were the one that took it there. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Keep going.
I don't like being back.
Check it out, Carl and Lisa.
Beautiful hairpiece, Stevie.
Pretty pet.
Thank you. Lovely.
It's a penetrator.
Nice. Oh. Really? You sure about that?
Pretty cool.
No,
fascinating.
All right, coming at number four this morning. Now, this sheep has a point to make. Take a look.
Oh, no.
He's back.
Yeah. I don't know whether we should be laughing. He's had terrible nightmares. Really bad night.
What does a sheep have nightmares about?
Mate, you don't want to know. You don't want to know.
Lisa. I meant lamb roast. She took it to a whole different awful level.
If you would like to head to the WWE, you can go to www.tickertech.com.au.
Do you want me to show you my move?
Yeah. You got one?
Yeah. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
So ready. You get on the rails.
Yeah.
And then you launch off, and I'm going to come down with you like this.
Right.
You ready?
Off you go.
All right, let's just go to the weather quickly.
Okay, right.
Right. Two.
Three, two, one, I win.
Coming that worked up, out well for me.
There's $10,000 in the last call in the Great Cash Giveaway. There's got to be a winner, so stay by your phone. And the two-year-old Ballarat boy is already on track.
Enough.
Our next one.
Enough.
That's right. Brad Pitt has shelled out $400,000 to build a gun range out back the chateau. We all know Angie loves her firearms. Nothing gets her going more than an AK-47. So, hey, you know, it's good to be Angie. What can you say?
What can you say?
Pop, and that was what was looking
for. Welcome home, sweetheart.
You said you were going to be home at 8.
They didn't meet up Mr. and Mrs. Smith for nothing. Yeah, there you go.
Open Gangnam Style.
Oh. How did he do it?
This thing.
How he does it.
Sticks. Doesn't it? I've had it in my head all morning. So I'm sorry if I've been a bit off my game.
You've not been off your game. You should play it every day. If that's off, Lord help us if we see on.
When you come to the school, you can actually have a try at everything. So,
Oh, that's disgusting. You are gross, man.
Why bother with the baking, eh?
Fuck gross.
Oh, no.
Look at the hand. Look at the hand on him. Chocolate hand.
Oh, Stephen. That's just so wrong.
Stevie Jacobs.
Oh. Mind you, who wouldn't want to be him this morning?
Yeah, or kissing him. What?
An incredible sculpture's made out of chocolate. It is the first time I've ever wanted to be a tree hugger. Carl and Lisa? Back to you.
He's like the kid. Remember the kid in Willy Wonka and the chocolate? Remember he ate too much chocolate? And what was his name? Gloop or something?
Yeah, something like that.
blew up.
He blew up.
Yeah.
That's what Stevie's going to do by the end of the show, folks. Stick around. It'll be fun.
is we are in the chocolate spray booth this morning giving Kirsten her biggest challenge ever. A giant chocolate teddy bear! Spray away, Kirsten! This is better than going into a tanning booth, Carl and Lisa, and it tastes even better! A big thank you to the Sabre Chocolate and Patisserie School. I'm feeling a little bit Willy Wonky. And remember, somebody has to lick this off, Lisa, Georgie and Carl.
Yes, I'm there. I'm so there. I can catch the 9:30 out of Sydney.
That's a bit trashy, isn't it?
No, it's chocolate.
There was a little bit too much excitement in your voice there for me, Lisa.
You needed to spray it straight into your mouth, Stevie.
See, that's what happened.
Get in there.
You had something similar done a couple of years ago on Derby Day.
Do you think it actually hardens? Or does it stay soft? I suppose body temperature would keep it soft. It'd be like ice magic, wouldn't it? Be great.
But oh, we've
gone to black. Come back,
Lisa.
To me.
Lisa. Okay. Lisa.
Come back to
Lisa Wilkinson.
I love that.
You need to go away for the weekend or something.
With ice magic, when you put it on top, how good is that combination of ice cream and the hard chocolate?
Good cover, darling. Good cover.
Look at that. There he is.
Thank you, Carl and Lisa. I just want to let you know I'm making my stand against the no handstand policy. If I can read the weather upside down, then kids can handstand around the country. So here it is. Cairns, fine and mostly sunny, 29. Brisbane and the Gold Coast, fine and sunny, light showers, possible early 20s. Sydney, partly cloudy and 22. A little morning frost in Canberra and 16. 19 in Melbourne, some possible late showers. Chance of morning rain in Hobart, 16. 21 in Adelaide. Possible showers, a few showers in Perth, 19. A hot, windy day in the Alice, 31. And Darwin, sunny and 34 degrees.
Stay there.
I'm staying.
Well, as you can see here, the back of the orangutan is extremely hairy.
Sorry, mate.
That's very funny. Over to you, Carl.
Well, every kid dreams of sliding down a fireman's pole, right?
What?
Proofreading is good, isn't it? And jumping into the fire engine to fight fires. But there aren't many of them left. Did you know that? Fireys up in Service Paradise are fighting to keep the tradition alive. And joining me now is Area Commander Mark Gribble. Mark, good morning to you. How are you?
Stay tuned for this one.
Get a loud girl.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
Just move your feet forward and back. You're not going to really go anywhere.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. You can't use your elbows. And you can't use your hands or your forearms. So if you hit something, this is scary. Oh, no.
Get it.
I think you get
him.
Go,
get him. Get him.
All right.
Get him.
I'm on it.
Get him. Girls, get that block.
Closing ceremony, getting up close and personal, and that is a great pink jumpsuit she's got on.
Great.
There's
song.
A lot of jumpsuit involved.
Oh, hey, what's going on there? Hey, hey.
What's the song? Princess of China.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great song, right?
Look at this. Very interesting.
There's something happening there, Dickie.
Yeah, it was backstage.
Oh, he just dropped his pick on him.
Did you say pick? Oh, thank God, Dickie.
Plectrum for the guitar. Right, right, turn off the lights. We're gonna lose our minds
tonight. What's the dealio? So a big thank you to Sweet Arts Paddington for this fantastic show. Details on our website.
We also have to thank Frank Lou and Kathy Murray.
We do. Amazing job.
Tirelessly for us to get all of these great clips. And all of our wonderful...
Thank you so much. Please. Good to see you again.
Great.
Great
to see this every day.
And a big cheers to you all at home for watching us. We really appreciate it. So, thank you to you. So where's your glass if you...